Now that my booth car's fixed, now I can get back to working on this car. So today's project is working on the metal and working on tire clearance. Took that tire off, gonna be putting that one on now. And the metal was already cut into that tire, so what I did was took a cutting wheel and we cut some slices on here. And just folding that under up behind here. So now whenever the tire rubs against this, you're gonna have a curved edge of metal and you're not gonna have a sharp edge, so it's not gonna cut into your tire as much. Still gonna hurt it a little, but not as bad. And for derby drivers, always remember this number one rule. Never cut what you can fold. Always keep as much metal on the car as possible. That's so you have more stuff to pack in later. Makes it stronger. So none of this I've taken off. All this has just gotten folded under. And here's the frame on our car. See, it's still gray. Very solid. This car was a good find when I got it. Nothing's rusted out on this at all. So the back of it's still fairly strong. And if you look underneath the trunk here, you can see the notch we cut in the frame. It's just now starting to bend. Look from under here, there's the frame curving. Used to be straight, but after its last run now, it's starting to fold up. And the idea behind notching the frame here is controlling how the trunk packs in. Now that this is folding, after another run or so, this bumper here will fold up, and that'll be sitting at the top of the car here, right where that notch is at. And then as the rest of this frame collapses in the trunk, the idea behind it is to get your bumper to go up here, then fold again and end up back here. So this entire area will be balled into a big, strong, ramming mess of metal, and yet you'll still be able to see out of your back window. If your trunk bends up too high, your bumper's gonna bend up and block your view and you can't really go backwards anymore. Then you're stuck using your front until it's wasted. So the best idea is to notch your frame, not too far back, but enough to get it to start rolling in without blowing out your humps of your car right here. And it all just packs in really tight. So far it's doing good. We're gonna have to see how it goes on this next run. And right here we have a problem. This got ripped during its last run. A car caught it on the side and ripped it out. I think I'm going to hit it with a sludge and beat it inside of the trunk here so it's sitting inside of there. That's why nobody catches on it anymore. That'll be nice and strong. And I cut all this stuff, folded this metal all over. It's a lot more solid. So that's today's project. If you look on the passenger side here, on this side, and compare it to the driver's side on the rear wheel, there's a huge difference in metal damage. This side got pounded on pretty bad. And if we walk around and look on the other side, that's pretty much still normal. Almost looks like it hasn't been through a derby. So what I'm gonna do is still do the same thing on this side, because it needs definitely wheel clearance, almost rubbing right now. I'm gonna cut notches up about that far up all along here and just take that metal and fold it under just like the other side. That's why there's no sharp edges and yet the metal's still there, so it's nice and strong. This car, when I bought it, actually could have been used on the road. It was roadworthy, nothing wrong with it at all. Just, it was in a wreck and they hit a pole on this back corner here. So they didn't want to get it fixed and I bought it. Good deal. Great car.